to be alive, I am. From day to day, we try again. A reason to win the Super Bowl, cause I know we can be a higher land. Praises to be alive, I am. From day to day, I try again.
Well, what's up, bro? When are you gonna get in full gear?
Upstairs, man. I'm going upstairs. You guys are welcome to come upstairs and check it out.
Well, cool, cool. Well, we're gonna go upstairs with Leroy and talk about the history of the whistle mount here. My main man. That's what's up. Let's do this.
Who that?
This is nice. So is this an original Saints helmet?
Not original Saints helmet, but it's a helmet I bought. Buy a new helmet every year.
Wow.
And make a new one every year as well.
What's it made of?
Sheet metal.
Did you design this yourself?
Yeah, many years ago. It used to be the opposite. It used to be flipped around. And we used to kind of wear it as a balancing act on our head like this.
Okay.
And if you ever noticed any other footage, it would have like a hard hat. I kind of wore it like this.
Right.
And then one of my buddies said, why don't we take the bulbous part, stick a helmet in it, flip it over.
Wow.
And it was born.
Wow, let's see how this works. Are you
the first, no, not at all. The first one was chicken wire and paper mache.
Wow.
No, only on defense.
Right.
And a dream for the whistle mount says this, and anybody who knows me knows this. My dream is, out of 68,000 people, just give me 10,000 Moseses, Popes, whistle monsters, fanatical fans, out of that 68,000. And if we can make it, this is the Bensons and the Saints, like a student section at LSU or a student section somewhere where they have a spot for the fanatical fans
right.
to go off. And, you know, whether they want to get sponsors, whoever, think of something like that. I mean, I don't mind paying. I've been paying for my ticket for 16 years.
Of course.
With the exception of Budweiser for 4 years. But, yeah, man, you know, we're very passionate people. And I think they should. I don't think they should do anything for us. We do our own thing, but
of course.
They can make it a little easier for us to have an advantage on, at the home field, in essence.
Because we are known to have the loudest crowd.
Baby.
That's it, there you go. Trust me, is it live? Is it Memorex? Is it HD? Is it Whistle Monster? Check this out.
I know a concert's 97 decibels, an airplane taking off is 120, because I own the world's record for the loudest human whistle.
What?
I just a little bit louder, a little more crazy, but yeah, and it's my record on MTV. I broke the record in 2002.
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, when the Super Bowl was a week away from Mardi Gras in 2002.
Oh, congratulations, man.
Right.
You know, that's, I guess they said it's true. God has a time for everything, for everybody, and I just was informed, so I learned something new today.
Yep, that's, we got to keep learning. That's the thing, man. You keep learning something every day is my motto. If the day you stop learning, that's the day you stop living.
That's what's up.
You got to learn, man.
From the one and only Whistle Monster. How did the Whistle Monster phenomenon start, and what inspired you to make this happen?
Well, let's see, about 16 years ago, I was, I've been a Saints fan all my whole life, like everyone else, but 16 years ago, I got compelled, I came up with a reason, I had an epiphany, I guess. I figured, I know I can whistle louder than the average person, and in the Dome, 68,000 people there with 3-13 seasons and stuff like that, there's a lot of hot air, so I figured I'd take that hot air, blow it through a whistle, and I provide the sound, and the Whistle Monster was born, kind of, so to speak. Yeah, but basically once I got, the first one was chicken wire and paper mache, and then Buddy D ribbed on me on the air. God rest Buddy D's soul, and Dilly's, he said, hey, Whistle, you got a wife? And it was on the news, I'm thinking, yeah, Buddy's gonna hook me up. He goes, I said, no, I don't have a wife, buddy. What's going on? He goes, I didn't think so. She wouldn't let you out the house looking like that.
He's throwing on you.
Right. So he got me, and we went to the drawing board, and we got this, buddy. So I appreciate him for the motivation.
Absolutely. Big shout out to Buddy D. Rest in peace, the voice of the Saints for so long. I mean, it's Saints dedication, but that's what the black and gold soul is all about, yo.
That's right, man.
Who that nation, man. That's what we live and die for.
That's right, black and gold, man. He ain't just saying it. Check that out. Yeah. He's bringing it. He's bringing it two levels.
three even.
Yeah.
And that's how we do it, y'all. We're gonna do this all day until the wheels fall off, as they say.
Yo, this is the Whistle Monster live from New Orleans. Bam!
Yeah, you're right. Who that?